Hi guys, this is Akanksha. Welcome to my YouTube channel all about English. As you all know, I love to teach English in fashion. I always take up topics which are red hot, the talk of the town topics. The one topic which is most trending and viral in the internet these days, and we keep on talking about the couple every day, is Virat and Anushka's wedding. So we'll be learning English with the help of this fairy tale wedding. But since I've already released my first part, I'll just give a brief review of all those words that we learned in my first conversation with you, and after that we'll jump on to the next part. So without wasting any time further, let's start up. Well, I'm Akanksha, don't forget. We learned words like the shades that the bridegroom chose to wear, the muted colors that they wore, the pale colors, the colors that were soft hued. The same was the color of the surrounding as well. They tried to be in sync with the color of the sky. It was an afternoon wedding, and therefore they chose colors that would like blend in with the Tuscan sky. Tuscan was the state in which the wedding took place, a venue in that state. Then I said the couple looked so fascinating. They were so alluring, so enticing. Enticing is the word that I'm trying to make you all learn. The couple looked so enticing. The wedding was so enticing that I'd say this duo would, you know, write an all new dictionary of fashion and style statements. It will be an inspiration for all the brides and grooms to be. Then I talked about how this wedding is making talks. It is the buzz, the rumor everywhere. It was the buzz. It was a rumor everywhere. Everybody wanted to know, when are the couple getting married? When is the duo getting married? So finally they have been hitched. They have got married. So buzz is basically a rumor, a gossip. You hear it and you say it, a hearsay, a chit chatter, a natter. And enticing is something alluring, something that captivates you. Enticing basically are advertisements, a wedding, something that, you know, attracts you, provokes you to get it. Maybe a food item may be so enticing to you. Maybe you get tempted by some smell. Maybe the smell from the bakery was enticing. Maybe a wedding was enticing, or the television advertisements that come entice you to a great deal, to a great level. So these were the words that I framed, and I was hamesha bolti hu English ko maze maze mein padho, listen to the listener and then speak. So playfully is something that you, when you are full of joy, when you enjoy doing things, it's called to be in a playful mood. A dog can be in a playful mood, a goat can be in a playful mood, you can be playful sometimes, a puzzle is sometimes playful. It's just meant to test your acumen, test the acuteness of your brain, the sharpness of your mind. Then we also came across words like ensembles, nuptials, costume, harmony. Well, ensembles are, or it's a word that we use when the things or the attire, our accessories, everything that we wear from top to bottom is in harmony, is in sync. Nuptials refers to a marriage or marriage-related vows or ceremonies. Costume is your apparel, your dress, your outfit, your attire, your wardrobe, or your accoutrements or your habiliments. All right, we'll be coming across these words again later in this conversation. So no need to worry if you're not getting it. Be patient, listen to the lecture as many times as you want, so that you may at least take or get a hold on the words. Sorry. Then I took a word, harmony. I said that ensemble is something when you wear and everything is in harmony, means everything is in concurrence, in agreement with everything else that you wear. Okay, then I told that the wedding took place in Tuscany. Tuscany was the state and Florence is the city where the venue was. They chose shades that would blend with the whimsical Tuscan surroundings rather than stand out. A wedding in the Italian vineyards. I said they chose shades that would mix with the surroundings mixed with the open venue. The venue was open. It was an afternoon wedding. So it was an amber sky. Amber sky means a yellowish kind of sky. So they chose pastel shades that would not look jarring under the sun. So there's the shades blended, amalgamated, fused, were in sync or harmonized with the surroundings. They went very well with the surroundings. With what kind of surroundings? With the whimsical Tuscan surroundings. Whimsical means something that is playful or can be lively, something vivacious. Something which means something which is lively but unpredictable. Like weather can be whimsical. If you open your window and see it raining, and 1 hour later again you open it and you see as a bright sun is shining overhead, then you will tell your mom, your friend, mom, it was raining 1 hour before and now I can see a bright sky. So the weather here in Lucknow, in Kanpur, in Trichy is so whimsical. Once it rains, the other hour, it is a sunny day. So this is whimsical. This is something which is like weather is so lively. It's pretty unpredictable. It's sportive. Like one of your friends can be whimsical, like somebody who has a very good mood. She talks to you like one of your best buddies, but sometimes she gets irritated. So you will say that friend, that Geetika is having a whimsical personality. She is happy when she is happy, but I don't understand her mood swings. Sometimes she gets irritated. So she has a whimsical personality. Then you can say Kapil Sharma. Like he has a great calming timing. His comic sense of humor is excellent. Just a second. Is excellent. His comic timing is excellent. But his sense of humor can offend sometimes. So you can say Kapil Sharma has a whimsical personality, but his sense of humor can sometimes offend somebody. Whimsical means he's lively, he's sportive. But sometimes he speaks such things, you know, which can offend. So that is one perfect word for Kapil Sharma, whimsical. And if you have some of your friends, your relatives in this manner, then you can definitely use this word on them. It is a positive word, yes. Then I said the shades that were chosen that blended with the whimsical surroundings and didn't stand out. Means the colors were blended, they were fused, they were amalgamated, and they never looked deserted. They never looked rejected or left out. It was a wedding in the Italian vineyards. In Italy, we have grapes, and from grapes we prepare wine. The destination of the afternoon wedding was a plush resort in an exotic location, which was indeed a sight to behold. The destination of the afternoon wedding was a plush resort, means a property which was luxurious, which was expensive, and very premium, called premium and deluxe. And it was an exotic location. Means an exotic location means a location out of the ordinary. Very good, very beautiful. Something that is a sight to behold. It was a sight for sour eyes. It was a sight to look at, to gaze at, look continuously, to observe for hours. Okay? Then I have framed a few sentences, which I think I'll be taking only a few of them because whimsical I've already explained. Then blend. Blend means to fuse, to amalgamate, like milk and water blend in so perfectly. Then you can say oil never blends in with water. Then you can say my expressions. When on my birthday, my friends brought a strawberry cake. I have an expression, or my expressions were a blend of happiness, surprise, but disgust, because I was not happy. I don't like strawberry flavor. Do you all like? I like chocolate cakes. Then you can say Manu's expression was a blend of surprise and disgust, or if you get a bad news or something like that. If you get a good news, suppose your expressions will be a blend of happiness and emotions. So this is how you can use blend. Or you can say the building was not in blend with its surroundings. Suppose in Jaipur you have all pink buildings and one building is like brown. You'll say this building is not in blend with its surroundings. Okay, then plush, you all know. I've made a sentence. grabbing a plush robe, Roly headed towards the spa. Means taking her plush garments, maybe a jacket or maybe some beautiful gown, something what is appealing. She grabbing her jacket, grabbing her plush robe, she headed towards the spa. Roly headed towards the spa. Then I felt the plush comfort of my bed. Your bed is something which is luxurious because you love it. It's so plush. So I felt the plush comfort of my bed. I'm feeling the plush comfort of my bed. Well, right now I'm sitting on a bed. So I'm definitely feeling the plush comfort of my bed. See. Then comes the word exotic. Exotic is something of foreign origin, which is not native. We can say that her beauty is exotic. Means Katrina Kaif, just for example, I know you all love Katrina Kaif. She's so pretty, yaar. The exotic beauty of Katrina Kaif makes heads turn because she's a perfect blend of a Kashmiri father and a US-based mother. So her beauty is exotic. Or native plants are disappearing because of the introduction of exotic species or exotic plants. Means those foreign breed plants that have been brought into India are growing at such a fast pace that they are eclipsing or, you know, a hurdle in the growth of our native plants. And behold, you all know, just behold my new watch, or behold, don't take it as a reference, please. I'm sorry. Then behold my new puppies. They are the latest addition to our family. Or just, I'm going to behold one of the greatest wonders of the world. So this is how you can use the words. Now this slide was already explained that day. I'll just read it out. The breathtaking view was matched by an equally spectacular decor. Spectacular means the view of the sky, the view of the venue was matched by a spectacular decor. Means the decoration that were done of the wedding venue were astounding, wondrous. The atmosphere was earthy. Means everything was floral. Everything was so earthy, so natural, so unrefined, crude, that it gave a homey feeling. The venue was totally in sync with the amber sky. Amber sky means the color of the sky. The color of the sky in the afternoon is amber. Means something yellowish, something saffron shade. Something which is like that color of gold. Golden sky, that yellowish sky, that color of ivory, that creamy color, chrome, blonde, beige, okay? The credits to the credits, all credits to the wedding planner who hailed from Lucknow and her wedding squad. It was a visual feast. So I said that the entire decor was planned by a girl and her wedding squad who hailed from Lucknow, who came or whose origin was Lucknow. They were natives from Lucknow. And the entire wedding was a visual feast. Means it was a treat to our eyes. It was enjoyable to our senses to see, hear, experience and everything. Now we are actually starting up with our first page of our part two, which is the magnetizing Indian bride, Anushka Sharma. Anushka Sharma looked peachy in her habiliments. What does that mean? That means Anushka was looking like a solid bride. She was looking soft, subtle, delicate, dainty. She was looking dandy in her beautiful habiliments. Habiliments means her dress, her ensembles, her outfit, her attire, her garments, her garbs, or her accoutrements. She looked peachy, she looked solid, perfect, magnetizing, fascinating, alluring in her habiliments. What is magnetizing? Magnetizing is something that attracts you, something that is classy, enchanting beauty. She looked an enchanting beauty, something divine, something out of this world, isn't it? So I'll just take it up again. The magnetizing Indian bride, Anushka Sharma, looked peachy in her habiliments. Magnetizing bride, the alluring, the enchanting bride, with the girl with an enchanting beauty. the divine look of the diva, the exquisite beauty, the exquisite looks of Anushka Sharma were so magnetizing, isn't it? She looked glamorous, like a glam doll. She was so sightly. Sightly means something you can gaze, you can look at, you can behold, okay? And the magnetizing Indian bride, Anushka Sharma, looked peachy, looked beautiful, solid, pleasing, dainty, dandy, wonderful in her habiliments. Habiliments is her clothing, her attires, her garments, her garbs, her robes, her outfit, her habiliments, her accoutrements as well, the word that I taught in my first part. Now, Anushka, the pretty, charming and comfy Indian bride. Pretty, charming and comfy. Comfy is something cushy, something easygoing, like cheerful, very restful, like a snug, homely feeling. When you're comfortable somewhere, you feel as if you're at home. You get that feeling of restfulness. You are so much at ease. You feel cozy, comfortable. You are at rest. You feel cushy. Means cushions give you a feeling of warmth. So comfy is basically that is something comfortable, something which makes you feel light-hearted. Cozy, that gives you a cushy feeling. Cushy feeling is when you touch a cushion, you feel soft, you feel as if something that gives you a feeling of warmth. So that kind of a feeling was she was sharing. She was easygoing, comfortable, she felt restful. She felt restful. She was like a snug. She had that homey kind of feeling. She was buoyant, airy, balmy. She was carefree. So the dress, her entire look, she looked pretty, charming and comfy. An Indian bride was pretty, charming and comfy. Comfy is super comfortable, or who is having and who is enjoying a easy going life. She was at ease. She was cozy. She felt warmth. She was restful and she felt as if she is back home. Then it's barely that we come across an Indian bride who sports freshly plucked lush hydrangeas in her hair and twins in a garland made of dusty pink and mild yellow roses. This sentence is a bit difficult to understand, but try to understand. मैं हिंदी में बोलूँगी, पहले आप सुनो. बहुत ही कम ऐसा होता है कि हम किसी एक इंडियन ब्राइड को देखते हैं कुछ ऐसा जो करती है डिफरेंट, लाइक उसने अपने अपने जूड़े पे क्या लगाया, फेक सॉरी नॉट इन अ फेक बन व्हाट वी कॉल जूड़े पे लश फ्लावर्स लगाए, माइल्ड येलो एंड पिंक फ्लावर्स, एंड शी वोर अ गार्लैंड और द एक्सचेंज्ड गार्लैंड्स दैट वर मेड अप ऑफ फ्लावर्स दैट वर लार्ज शोई एंड फ्लैशी. बहुत ही कम ऐसा होता है कि हम किसी ब्राइड को इतने डल पेस्टल शेड्स में देखते हैं और इंस्टेड ऑफ वेयरिंग दोज fake hair buns, they are using freshly plucked flowers. So this is very rare. This is what I'm trying to explain here. It is barely that we come across an Indian bride who sports freshly plucked flowers, lush hydrangeas in her hair, and twins means marries in a garland made of dusty pink and mild yellow flowers, roses basically. So hydrangeas, it is very rarely that we see a bride who's sporting hydrangeas, big flowers on her bun. Hydrangeas are clusters of showy and flashy flowers that we basically grow in Italy or in Netherlands. Clusters of showy and flashy flowers are called hydrangeas. And she twins in a garland, or the couple exchange a garland made up of mild pink and yellow roses. Mild pink and yellow and dusty shade here refers to some dim shade, to some calm and serene colors, color that is appealing, summer shades, unpolished, unpointed and unsharpened, blunt colors, colors which are blunt, don't speak out loud, which are unsharpened, not sharp colors. They're not like pinching or piercing through your eyes. They are very dull, dim, tempered, cool, consoled colors, mild colors. Dusty means here dull shades, shades like of which are summer shades, light, cool colors. Isn't so? Is it clear? She was having roses, freshly plucked roses on her bun, and she wedded in a garland that was made up of mild colored pink and yellow roses. So is that clear? She looked casual and never over the top. Casual here means that she looked very carefree. She never was like struggling with her dress, never. She was super comfortable. She was easygoing, peppy, carefree. She was walking, talking, eating, smiling out. She was laughing. She was fully enjoying her wedding. So that means she was sparkling like a diamond. She was low pressure. She never felt that pressure. She never had that cumbersome look coming on her face. She was carrying a dress super comfortably. She had that cushy feeling. She was airy. I mean, she was comfortable. She never had the tension to be like shown on her face. She was casual. She was never over the top. Over the top means she never looked overstated. Her dress was not gaudy, not chunky, not elephantine. It was perfectly figured. It was sophisticated and in shades that were in complete fusion with the amber skies. Clear? Okay. She never looked over the top, but she looked casual. She looked carefree, peppy, sparkling. Her sunny side was up. She was lively. She was smiling. She was full of life. She was vivacious. Isn't it? Yes, she was vivacious. Then, she looked casual in ensembles which looked fuss-free and breezy. Means her attire, her ensembles, her accoutrements, her costume, her dress, her attire, her apparels were super comfortable. They were fuss-free. They were breezy, light-weighted. They were casual dress. It was a dress that was never gaudy, that was not overweight, not overstated. It was light, breezy, airy, balmy, super comfortable, animated. Animated is sometimes really feel like very light-hearted and low-pressured. She had quick access to flowers. Means she wore garlands made up of pink and mild yellow roses flowers kind of garlands. And she had sported those lush hydrangeas on her bun, on her mane. Mane is also that a strand of hair, okay? So the entire feeling with flowers was rustic and organic. Rustic and organic. Organic is something natural. When you are in touch with soil, in touch with flowers, you feel that homey kind of an atmosphere. An atmosphere that is pleasant, natural, home-like, homely, earthy atmosphere. And rustic means when you're not getting married in a big hotel, in a big mansion, instead you choose a venue which is covered and decorated with flowers, you get that rustic feeling, country, a feeling of a countryside, that primitive feeling that you only get when you visit a village or you meet people from your native places, your birthplace, your origination, your place of birth. So you get that rusting, that countryside feeling, that feeling of home, an artless feeling, an unsophisticated feeling. Artless feeling means honest feeling. When you are touched, when you apne mitti se jab jude ho, you feel so earthy, so natural, so homey. You feel artless in an unpolished, in an unrefined, in an unsophisticated world. Sometimes it's good to be who you are. Don't fake it. Be as real as possible. When you visit people who live in villages, you'll see they are so artless. They are unsophisticated, but you'll still love them. They are so true. They are honest. They are genuine people. So when you are in touch with those people, when you feel that rustic feeling, that means you are in touch with your countryside people. You feel so organic, natural. When you're in touch with unpolished people, people who are not refined, who don't know, who are so ingenuous, they're so gullible, they easily believe what you say. So those kind of people, you get that feeling, you get that organic, that positive feeling when you are in touch with flowers, in touch with trees, floral decoration. You feel true, you feel true to your senses, because things are so real, not faked out. They are unrefined, unpolished, primitive feeling. So I think it's clear now. Now, I think this will be the last slide of our lecture. Yes, all were astounded at the vintage English colors of Anushka's dress. Means vintage English colors, all were astonished, all were like surprised by the vintage. Vintage means the colors that she chose were pastel shades, shades which are of a time late but are still valuable, still classy. She didn't go for those jarring red, maroon, orange, saffron shades. She chose dull shades which are always classy, perennial shades, shades that are antiquated, shades which are old yet valuable. Okay, so vintage is your car. You can have a vintage car, means a car that might belong to your grandfather's father but is still old but is still more valuable. So vintage colors, vintage car, vintage valuables. So vintage is used for things that are perennial, that are classic, classy plus classic. You watch that movies, old classics, because they're old and old is always gold. So remember that vintage colors, English colors of Anushka's dress, that were old vintage colors. It was a blush pink lehenga. She wore a blush pink lehenga. Blush, what is the color? Blush means when you smile, you get that blush on your face. Blush is basically a glowing, a rosiness on your face, on your cheeks, scarlet. A hint, a tinge of something blossoming or blooming of flowers, the real colors of flowers, the rosiness of rose, rosy cheeks. Why do we apply rouge on our faces? To get that blush, we apply that blusher on our face. So that is the color of the lehenga that she wore, a blush pink lehenga that was blooming, that was blossoming. Okay, with mild green and a dash of peacock blue. Means it was a blush pink lehenga in which embroidery was done with mild green color. Mild green means calm, serene, tempered green, light green. Green which is not over the top. Very, cool kind of green color. And a dash of peacock blue. Means dash means and a tinge, hint of peacock blue. Means little, somewhere you'll see drop by drop that blue color. Means a drop of blue somewhere, or a grain kind of blue. Very small, small streaks of blue. Or you can say a touch, or just a trifle mention of the blue color. A dash of something means, okay, I'm wearing a black white top with a dash of pink in it. So this is my white top with black and a dash of pink. But this is still big, but a presence which is even less than this. Trifle presence, very less, very little. Just a drop of something, a tinge of something. Something which is like scattered into places. This mutti bhar chawal poore mein phila diye. So this is my room is filled with dash of rice, means pieces of rice scattered everywhere. A dash of peacock blue with tropical flora and fauna. It was a blush pink lehenga, means a rosy pink lehenga with mild green, cool, calm, serene, tempered green, light green, and a dash, and a special or a few, and you'll see very little places that have a touch of blue color. A dash means a tinge, a hint, a touch, or a drop, a bit of blue color somewhere. Dash means a bit or a drop, tinge, hint of something, very little, something which is present in very whose presence is like almost negligible. Like if some child attends a class very rarely, then we can say that yes, his presence is just like is just dashed. Means sometimes he comes, very rarely, it is very barely that you can see him in class. So dash means very, presence is little, with a dash of if you wear a black shirt and it has white drops, white points somewhere, and you see it, I'm wearing a black shirt with a dash of white in it. With a hint of white, with a tinge of white, with a touch of white. White in it is like trifle, okay? The white color in a black shirt that I wear is trifle, means very little hint of white, by just by bits or by drops. Now, I'm also saying that the lehenga had tropical flora and fauna embroidered on it. Tropical means something that is relating to the tropics. tropical, you know, something equatorial, lush, something torrid. Tropical means equatorial. मैंने उसके लहंगे में जो एम्ब्रॉयडरी थी उसमें कुछ ट्रॉपिकल फ्लोरा, ट्रॉपिकल बटरफ्लाइज, बर्ड्स बने हुए थे. ट्रॉपिकल मीन्स बर्ड्स बिलोंगिंग टू द ट्रॉपिक्स, टू द इक्वेटोरियल रीजन, टू द लश ग्रीन फॉलिएज. इक्वेटोरियल रीजन इज फिल्ड विद यू नो इंसेक्ट्स, एनिमल्स, बिकॉज इट इज सो डेंस. द फ्लोरा एंड फौना इज अनमैचेबल. दे हैव इन्यूमरेबल वैरायटी ऑफ फ्लोरा, फौना, प्लांट्स, एनिमल्स. सो द लहंगा वॉज डैश्ड विद दोज थिंग्स, विद बर्ड्स, बटरफ्लाइज हु वर ऑफ ट्रॉपिकल ओरिजिन. हैंड एम्ब्रॉयडर्ड इन सिल्क फ्लॉस मीन्स दिस एंटायर वर्क वॉज डन इन सिल्क. The embroidery on the blush pink lehenga. Now, it was a blush pink lehenga. She had it. She had embroidery on it. The embroidery was done of butterflies, of birds, of tropical flora and fauna. But the embroidery was done with a silk floss. Floss means thread. Or you can say floss, you can say basically thread or wire or strand. Or ribbon, something you know, fibers of silk, threads, wires, cords. Just learn it. Cords, wires, threads, floss, fiber. Floss, fiber is already into your mind. Floss, fiber. Then thread is also something you know. Wire, strand, cord, ribbon, string. How to call it? Pink, blush pink lehenga. A lehenga which is a rosy in color. It has embroidery on it. Embroidery is that something that you do with a needle. Work, handwork, handicraft, okay? Handwork, handicraft, or elaboration, embellishments. Embellishment is embroidery, which I'll explain you later, I guess. So embroidery is something that the handwork that you do with a needle, handicraft, or the elaboration on a dress done with threads or fibers, silk floss, fiber, or you can say thread, wire, cord, string, thread, wire, cord, string. Just learn it. Thread, wire, cord. Just bring, use your mind. Something which is like string, a wire, a thread. What else? A fiber, a floss, a cord. These things are categorized under floss. With tropical flora and fauna, hand embroidered in silk floss. Exotic birds and butterflies were rendered on it. I've already told you, exotic means something that is of foreign origin, strange, anomalous, beautiful, stimulating, something riveting. See, exotic basically means something of foreign origin, but it is also used for something that is attractive, alluring, something riveting, that rivets you, attracts you, something stimulating, that stimulates your senses, something so sharp, so brilliant, so dazzling, something glazing with fire, something so much displaying, something so much showy, something really that is attractive. So sorry. Exotic birds and butterflies were rendered on it. Rendered means were displayed on it, evinced on it, portrayed, produced, pronounced, elaborated on it. It was a blush pink lehenga on which embroidery was done with threads, cords, wire, or you can say wire is something you can use but not usually, fibers or silk floss. And it had tropical flora and fauna. Tropical means lush green, lush flora and fauna belonging to the tropicals, belonging to the tropics, from an area where we have a variety, a diversification of birds and animals, especially snakes and all those things also in tropical areas. But birds and butterflies are in abundance there. So lehenga was embroidered. Embroidered means to handicraft something, something which in which embellishments are being done, something in which we have worked upon with needle and thread. Okay? Exotic flora and fauna were rendered. Exotic means something that is stimulating, something of foreign origin, something you have never seen before, something a sight, something sight to behold, something extraordinary, out of the ordinary, something then you can say stimulating, something engrossing, rare, something that you barely see, something riveting, intriguing, something riveting. It's not intriguing, it's intriguing, something alluring, something stimulating is something exotic. Exotic is something that attracts you. Immediate, like if I give you some exotic vegetables to eat, you'll be like, wow, I'm amazed. These are so attractive. It means something that is stimulating your senses. Something so riveting, intriguing, engrossing. Got it? So I've explained the word exotic. Exotic birds and butterflies were rendered. Rendered means displayed, showed, evinced, portrayed or embroidered, pronounced on something. Bana hua kuch, display hua, dikh raha hai aapko, which you can see. Something written, scribbled, drawn, something depicted that you can see as displayed or somewhere. Evinced, evinced mean to show. Then, these gave the lehenga the subtle vibe it boasted of. Means everything from top to bottom when combined gave the lehenga the subtle, the fine vibe, the feeble, the fragile look, the feeble look means the delicate look, the dainty, the dandy look, the feeble means the light look, the light-hearted, the beautiful look, the subtle, serene, ethereal look it boasted of. Means ek aisa look jo ek lehenge ko chahiye hota hai wo puri tarike se usme tha. Boasted of means it wanted something. Means though the colors were pastel, the designs were floral, but everything was excellent. Something that was subtle, ethereal, something calm to the senses, but still that spoke more than it could anywhere. Means something that was beautiful, these colors, these embroidery, the flora, the fauna, the exotic animals rendered on it, the exotic birds rendered on it, though gave the lehenga subtle vibe, but still everything was, when combined, gave it a boost. It was something that we could look at. It was something to be looked at. It was so conspicuous. It was something that spoke for itself. It was out of the ordinary. So I think this was my lecture, and thanks for watching it. I hope you all liked it. And if you really liked it, please don't forget to like it. It gives me a lot of energy. Then don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel, All About English, with me, Akanksha. Thanks a lot for watching it, and wait for more videos to come. Please write your comments down, because I really look forward to them. Thanks a lot. Thank you for watching the video. I hope it was fun, and please tell me if I really need suggestions. I'm open to all your suggestions for improvement. Thank you.